Yo guys, welcome to RenderRam. Today we're gonna cover 5 super obvious features that you either knew your whole life or you discovered them just now after 500 years of using 3ds Max. Make sure to stay till the end of the video for a cool bonus feature. So let's dive deeper into the known unknown depths of 3ds Max. Our first feature is gonna be planar edge removal in ProBoolean. So in this example, I have a box which has a turbo smooth with 2 iterations and I have a default sphere. So now if I want to boolean this box with this sphere, I'm going to go to my compound objects here, click on ProBoolean, start picking and click here, and voila, you have a beautiful model. Except everything is messed up. You have all these edges here and there is a way to fix that. So if you go to advanced options here, here you have the planar edge removal. And if you click on no edge removal, you will get a much cleaner result. But there is one problem with this option. If you put edit poly to your ProBoolean, and if you go to vertex mode, you will notice that it leaves a lot of these scrap vertices. So these are not connected with anything. So now if we delete this and go to our ProBoolean, and if we pick remove only invisible, and apply edit poly again, we will just have the edges that the original box and our sphere contained in the beginning. So from this point, you can start cleaning your booleans for that perfect mesh of yours. Our next feature is gonna be lock, or how to lock an object and prevent it from moving. So in this example, I have this beautiful teapot here. I also have 2 cameras. You can see a camera 1 here and camera 2 here. I bet a lot of times when you're messing with your scene, messing with everything, that sometimes you would accidentally move your camera around without noticing it, and later you would have problems with that. Well, there is an easy option in Max on how to lock some objects permanently. So, for example, I'm gonna select both of these cameras, and if you go to hierarchy panel here, and if you go to link info, here you can lock objects from moving, rotating and scaling. So if you click on all of these, your objects are now locked. So my move tool doesn't work. If I want to rotate these objects, they're just not moving, but you can still select them as usual. The same thing applies with any object. So I can lock this teapot, for example. I can lock the moves, so I can rotate it still as usual. I can scale it, but when I want to move it, I just can't do anything. Our third feature is going to be automatic window crossing. So what is window crossing? I bet you all know this. So this is this button here. So let me just quickly show what it does. So when this is off, when you make a selection like this, it will select all 3 objects. Keep in mind that the selection goes in the middle of the object. And it will look like this. But when you turn this on and you do the same selection, it will only select the objects that are fully within the selection. So it will only be this one. But there is a way to make this thing automatic. If you go to customize, preferences, here you have the scene selection section. And when you turn on auto window crossing by direction and hit OK, this is what happens. If I do a selection from left to right, it's gonna do the crossing option. But if I do it from right to left, it's gonna do a window selection. Our fourth feature is gonna be delete selected animation. So whenever you import an object in your scene and it has some sort of animation that you don't need, there is a way to delete all keyframes from that object or from your whole scene with just one button. So if I pause this animation now, I can, for example, select this helper. I see these keyframes, or I can select maybe multiple helpers here. So you could just make a selection here, press the delete button, but what you don't know is that maybe, as you can see here, there are some keyframes that are hidden off your timeline. So to be sure that you deleted everything, what you could do is click on animation tab, go to delete selected animation, and all of the keyframes will be done. Now you can notice that only keyframes from this object are deleted, but if I want to delete everything, just hit Ctrl A, animation, delete selected animation, and that is that. And for our fifth feature, we have a basic 3D Studio Max setup feature that I thought literally everybody does, but I was surprised to how many people don't have this thing set up. So whenever you have a fresh install of Max, or it doesn't even matter, you can do it right now. Go to Customize, Preferences. So what you could do, set your scene undo levels from 5, I have this at 500. Next, when you go to Files tab, you want to have your Autoback files much larger than this. I usually have this at 30 because number 3 will save only the last 15 minutes of your work, where 30 will save more than 2 hours of your work. Next thing that I do, if you go to General, you can see this box here. You can see I have 3 decimals here, 4.458. I usually set this up to 5, so whenever you click 5, click OK, you have 5 decimals here. Sometimes this can come really handy. And now for our bonus feature. If you want to be cool, if you want to be customized, tuned up, pimped up, you can set your custom Max splash screen. Check this out. If I start my Max, look at this. Wapa! You can have your custom Max splash screen. Let me show you how you do that. So you open up your Photoshop. You create any splash screen image that you like. You can pick any resolution that you like. Just don't go super crazy on the resolution pixels. After you're satisfied with the image, you need to save the image as splash.bmp. So, capital S, splash.bmp. You save that image on your desktop, and once it's on your desktop, you need to move it to your root Max folder. So, take a look at this. When I start 3ds Max 2021, it has a default splash screen. Now, if I go to my splash folder here where I saved the image, right click, copy, I go to my C, program files, Autodesk, 3ds Max 2021, right click, paste, click continue, and now when I start my Max 2021 again, I have a custom splash screen. But there is a big but here. This procedure works only with Max 2021 and earlier versions. For Max 2022, I'm guessing for 2023 also, is a little bit different procedure for that. So to make this work in Max 2022, you also need to save your splash image in the root folder of Max 2022. So if I go to my Max 2022, you can see that I have my splash.bmp file here. But what you need to do is you need to right click on your Max icon. So this is my Max 2022 icon. Right click it, right click again, go to properties, and now you need to add this. I'm gonna write this text down in the description so you can copy paste it. So you write this, click OK, and now when you run your Max 2022, you're gonna get your sexy new splash screen. That's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed today's depths. I hope you learned something new. See you in the next video. Stay cool and happy renderings. Bye.